So I managed to do a new firmware, but I don't like firmwares. So I managed to destroy the idea of new firmwares that are based on OpenWrt on this way. So it started, Janos, in the lightning talk of the previous battlemesh. He showed us a way of using a template of a configuration for a router and saying, OK, I want this template to apply to 5 routers with different values, like, for example, different IP addresses, different seed, different channel Wi-Fi. And I like that idea. This is what I wanted. And that helped me to start to think seriously on doing that. And after his talk, I said to him, OK, this is nice, but I would like to change also to have multiple templates, not only one template that I, and to have multiple devices on it. So thinking about this 1 year, this is the current state of the project, and let's see what goes next. So what is a firmware? Something that you put on your antenna, on your radio, that requires effort, no? I mean, this effort is done by OpenWrt. You have alternatives, but requires a huge infrastructure, huge knowledge of giving support to devices and so on. So the firmware, it doesn't require effort because it's based on OpenWrt tools. So here I'm just giving some helpers to understand what OpenWrt guys did. ImageBuilder is a tool that allows you to use a generic or custom-based image for different devices with different packages, injecting different configuration files, and Temba, that comes from template-based pseudo firmware, allows you to put the configuration files you want. Also, you can select the kind of packages you want to include. So the motivation is, so I'm a network operator of a network right now of 25 nodes that run QMP 321. QMP is a firmware that uses BMX6. That right now I think it's deprecated and we should migrate to BMX7. We will see what happens. So, but we stick for this version because it was like the latest development version from 2015. And we would like to, okay, how we can get a stick to the latest stable release, because this looks very difficult. Because you have your own firmware, and you have an upstream firmware, and you have an integration thing that looks like difficult. Another motivation was to kill the two-layer abstraction configuration, because we have the configuration of OpenWrt, and on top of it, another configuration of our firmware. In our case, was QMP, and you had to use the QMP thing to override the OpenWrt values. But sometimes the QMP didn't expect some values, and weird things happen. Avoid manual configuration after flashing devices. This was another important thing, that after you flash the device and you ensure through your validations that it works, you just have to power on, and that's it. This is also then useful when you are provisioning virtual machines for doing a testbed, a virtual testbed, because you just need to run all the images. You don't need a orchestrator or something that configures after powering it up. And also, and the most important things, to take care of network operators and motivate users to learn and contribute. Because sometimes in the firmware, we see the developer's ego, no? To say, look what I'm capable of doing. And when users or network operators require very specific things like, yes, yes, but I want this version of this firmware that is from 2012. OK, let's do it. I mean, it's just changing the make file and putting some things and recompiling everything. And this is easy now. I hope so. The benefit is that, yes, after you flash the device, it has the expected setup in the router, but you can continue. So it's like a good snapshot that, well, where everything works. And after that, you can add things. And if things go weird, you can go to the reset to defaults in case you are using a squash FS image. Very easy to adopt to any existing firmware or configuration. So let's think, okay, this network works with Babel, so I take the configuration file and I see what things I want to be static and what things I want to be dynamic, and from there I can replicate the firmware. And I also can find exactly the versions that I need to have very hard compatibility with the existing network. So this is a very thin layer between OpenWrt and the custom firmware. So very close to the OpenWrt community. Problems and errors that I'm having. Wrong target is flashed. And OpenWrt doesn't flash it. A way to solve this would be to add more automation on the flashing process and validations. So to add something like, okay, Ansible, I want this image to this target, and Ansible does checks the target or probably checks more things, automating the flashing part. And missed to check the safe current configuration, because using this thing, you don't want the previous configuration. So you don't have to take care about the backward compatibility of configuration files. You are overriding everything. If you don't uncheck that, then you run on problems. But so these problems can be solved with the automation thing. Tools about Temba. We have the Temba CLI. That is an environment, hackable environment, based on templates, ERB templates, because this is based on Ruby, but it can be it can be re-implemented in any language, because it's Temba CLI is 700 lines of code, and I'm not very great programmer. I think you can do a better job than me, and it's very easy to use. We use the templates of Ruby, and also the YAML files. YAML files allows you to do inherited variables. And this is the structure I see that I need. 10 global YAML example. This means that I propose this example, but you should modify for your community. Because, for example, by default, it adds in the sheet giphy.net. And probably you want to change this to FunFoyer, FiFunk, whatever, your community network. Or also you have a different MTP server, if you want to have a local MTP server, or your network has an intranet. Or a generic password, and so on. There's also a 15 packages YAML, that is the sets of packages you can have. It can be switch of packages for different routing protocols. You can, from there, you can say, okay, this image is for 64 RAM device HFlash. This is a low device with fewer RAM, so we have to get rid of some of the packages. So it helps a little bit to do some good pre-configuration of packages. We have the devices that at the moment is mixed between roles and devices. So in general, the 90% of the network is just one role. And in my case, I try to have very few devices to avoid a very difficult network to manage. And after all these variables, we have the nodes. What nodes we want to apply this configuration. So you have node one with things inherited from the previous variables, and you can compile multiple of it. So this remembers me to this kind of script topologies where you say node one looks like this, node two looks like this. You have a YAML explaining it, and you generate firmwares for all of them. So very interesting for virtual networks that provision these images. The usage is right now simply as rake. Rake is the make of Ruby. So it works this way. And so the script, what it does is to merge all YAML files in one YAML file to have everything in one file. So then the inherited thing works. So as this is a Ruby thing, we can put on top of it a Ruby on Rails thing where we can have a form to allow users that don't know how to make the OpenWrt environment to do an image. And let me take a risk and do a demo. So we select, this is the real thing that is being used right now. So we select the regular alpha and X. Regular means this is the 90% of nodes that work with VMX6 and so on. So we see test one, and we select a Wi-Fi channel, and we select a subnet, and we build the firmware. So we are just changing that parameters using the image builder. And it takes between 5 and 10 seconds to generate the image.
Except for the panel.
And what we have is all these things. So you can. These are all the YAML variables used. You have the sysupgrade image, the factory image, the etc template before applying the variables and after applying the variables. So it's like you have everything to test by yourself, or if you want to switch to another tool, or if you need to ensure what you are doing. And we have the image builder thing that facilitates usage of custom OpenWrt image. So the script is 150 lines, and I have extra documentation. What can you do with that? You can select a specific OpenWrt version. You can compile image builder in multiple architectures. You can put custom packages, and you can put custom patches. So I know this is very easy things, but if you try to do it on your own, you will end up with 5 or 10 hours of work. And if you don't automate the process, 1 month later, or you will require again to understand what you did. And the future work, what can we do after this, is an easy way, like, OK, I take an old backup of a firmware that is deprecated and put it in a new image. So instead of having that form, would be to put, like, upload your backup here. And so it will take the most recent packages and kernel version. And this sometimes works because there's a lot of innovation in a lot of layers. And you can have interesting improvement. This means that breaks could break the configuration backward compatibility, but I think it's sometimes interesting to have it. Improve the forms, more forms for other use cases. I mean, the form part, the web development part on this, can be very creative on how you want to present this information to the user so he's able to do all the magic. I mean, this part is like the, if you see the chef libremesh.org, it's very similar, but their approach is different because they want to make one firmware for all the network the same, and this is like very specific. So this has all more broad applications, not only for community network, also for testing corporate networks where you want the same firmware and other things. And Ansible playbook to do a massive upgrade in mesh network. I did some script long time ago, and now I feel comfortable to work on that again. When that time QMP downloaded the same image for all nodes, but now we can upload that firmware for that node. So then we have more control, and the result expected looks like to be better. And then a playbook to change the Wi-Fi channel. And that's it.
Thank you. A few questions, maybe? James?
Are you a streaming?
I'm?
So I'm going to be really rude and really brutal right now. If it's not an OpenWRT, it doesn't exist.
Huh?
If it's not part of OpenWRT, if it hasn't been upstreamed, as far as I'm concerned, it doesn't exist.
Exactly.
I'm not going to use any tools that are external to the OpenWRT build scripts. It's tempting. People have done scripts, and then you build your network. Okay, in my case, it's an experimental network. And then suddenly exam season happens. And exam season is when you don't exist, when you're a lecturer. And then you come back, and you find that the project has been abandoned. Okay, that it has disappeared. I'm not going, it's nothing personal, it concerns everyone here, I'm not going to trust any project that's not getting upstream into OpenWrt.
I like what you say. I mean, I agree with that. I think this is like a gap in the OpenWrt toolset.
Absolutely.
And this is my proposal. I don't feel with the... I mean, this is one-man project right now. I mean, it's a community effort, but I'm the only one that is working on that. So I don't feel ready for that step. But
with the OpenWrt guys.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I'm doing this presentation, because I think now we can start. I mean, these few weeks ago, it's improving, and it's taking a direction. And it's easy to being rewrite to another language or whatever, because it's very few lines of code. And I don't want that the project depends on me. So I'm...
We're in full agreement. So you use the Rake and the...
Ruby on Rails.
Ruby, right?
Yeah.
I did a lot of Ansible. I did also some Puppet, and I had like headaches to look at the Ruby code on Puppet. I don't have anything against the Puppet community, but for me, as
no, this is not Puppet.
No,
thing.
But the templating you used with the YAML and Rake, and you mentioned Rake.
ERB.
Rake. This is Ruby.
The templating is very simple.
Okay. Why don't you use just Ansible? Because Ansible can do local templating. Yeah, Jinja.
Legacy reasons. Janos started this. I improve it. I agree. I probably switch to Python because I won't do that alone.
You inherit. I mean, it's the same, but if it's written in Ansible, at least I think you can get a lot of more contributions than just.
Yeah. I mean, this is in a stage of, is this good? Is this idea good? So how this should continue? I'm open to that. If it depends only on me, this will be this way. But I'm open to change it, to get more contributors, to get more interest. I agree. So this is, I mean, the image builder is in shell, bash shell script. The other things are in Ruby, and I'm thinking to use Ansible because I like. So you see, it's.
Thanks for giving us so much support that you can give WRTs. But you trust us so much. regarding this topic, so there's currently something going on. One problem by, so I think there are multiple projects try to do something similar, so we Paul's phone and Moritz are working on some project.
Yeah.
Are you aware of it? So they have some firmware builders, so that you can click on a web GUI, I want this and this package for this port, and when you click a button and wait 5 seconds, and then you can download the specific image.
Yeah.
So use just the web UI for the image builder. So for people using the Windows system, they can just use the web UI, click some buttons, and then have a specific image. So from the OpenWrt project, we would like to promote this and make it something, some sort of official.
Yeah.
Probably we can put this together. I'm not really active, so probably talk with Moritz.
What's the name of it?
I just shot my email, but I couldn't find it.
Fine, Moritz. I think it's firmware generator. It's
something
like this.
Yeah.
not easy to find.
Yeah, I recognize that I'm not the only guy doing that. That's why this is not merged, this is a discussion. I tested the Chef Libre Mesh and I didn't like the ideas behind it. And I tried it. You can see like some interaction from me saying, can we have this feature? No? Okay, I will do it my own as I need. And from there we will see. I mean, and the Moritz one, I don't know. I would like to see what he did. But what I have to say is that I feel very comfortable about this software thing because it's very simple. I want it to be very simple. I don't want to... I have other things to do in life than code. I don't need to...
Okay. Well, thank you again.